Amid the dusty ruins of a plundered city, a building boom is creating order out of chaos. Cash from overseas is bringing life back to Kabul. There's more confidence, more vitality, and a hunger for one creature comfort that makes life complete. During Taliban times, this is where television ended up. All art and entertainment was banned. Now, the box is back, thanks to a family set to become Afghanistan's new media moguls. This is Tolo TV, broadcasting around the clock in 12 cities across Afghanistan.
This is where we transmit from. Transmissions are controlled from this place.
And this is its founder, Melbourne stockbroker Saad Mohseni. He left Afghanistan as a child for an upbringing in Australia. Now he's joined a trickle of returnees back to help rebuild his country.
Deep down, we all felt that we would come back at some stage. It's an exciting place to be in. I mean, it sounds really bizarre, but it's almost like being in New York or London. There are things happening, you're always busy.
At his morning news meeting, Saad Mohseni encourages his staff to be bold, rigorous, and without favour. And in a city with daily bombings, kidnappings, and payback murder, that takes courage. The big story of the day is a demonstration outside the home of a warlord.
The whole district's been very volatile of late, and it turned very violent. That it's been going on for some weeks now.
Covering the job is 19-year-old cameraman Quayus Akhmadia, who's been shooting for just 3 months. While many in his generation are watching television for the first time, he's making it, along with 300 other mostly young people at Tolo.
You get beaten up, you get threats, people have been killed. It's a very difficult job, but nonetheless these young kids seem to carry on.
Tolo Television is truly a family affair for the Mohsenis. Brother Jahid also has a finance industry background in Melbourne. He's Tolo's chief operating officer. And having left Afghanistan when she was just 4, sister Wajma has returned to run marketing and design.
I think it was always a feeling I had, being brought up in an Afghan household, hearing all the old stories from my parents, you know, being brought up here, I always had a feeling that I'd come back. It's a different life here, obviously, and it's very tough and it has its moments, but you would not be able to find any experience like this anywhere else in the world.
It's a relatively small place. So
Tolo's mission is not only to inform, but to entertain. In a conservative nation, offending sensitivities is always a risk. But in a country not used to laughing at itself, humour has become a panacea.
Nizam! Otash!
Two years ago, it was almost impossible to ridicule a politician or a minister, but they do it on a nightly basis, and they have broken the spell. And it's very important because some of the politicians are beginning to laugh at themselves as well.
Out on the road, news cameraman Quayus Akhmadia is in trouble. The demonstration is getting out of hand, and as his video footage shows, it ends in running gun battles between protesters and the warlord's militia. Two onlookers are shot and killed, Quayus is attacked and beaten, and his camera stolen. Soon he's back at the station, dusting down a new one for the next story. At least he saved the tape for the night's news.
We are obviously exposing corruption. We talk about drugs. For us, the danger is constant. We have to be wary of it. It doesn't change the way we operate. But we don't kid ourselves. This is a tough neighbourhood.
The Australian-reared Mohsenis have moved in on the ground floor in an industry that promises to flourish under a new democracy.
And most of these kids wouldn't have even used a computer up until 2002.
As well as Tolo TV, they run a radio station, publish a magazine, and there are plans for a $1 million feature movie. This from a family with absolutely no media experience anywhere else.
We're relatively speaking successful in what we did. So that gave us the confidence, it gave us the contacts, it gave us the ability to be able to operate businesses. And these are things that we obviously have brought back with us.
So I really encourage other, you know, Afghans to come out to help in the reconstruction process. And give a little bit back to the country, and a lot of these people didn't have a choice to leave.
A nation with three decades of war and conflict behind it is being informed and entertained once more, with the help of a new generation of entrepreneurs schooled and skilled abroad. And working with them on these dangerous streets, the youngsters of Afghanistan's new age of television.